This is a WildAx Elara. It's based on the Mercedes Sprinter van. It's just short of 7 meters long, and it's a really nicely finished motorhome. The level of finish in this is really smart, and in fact, the outside, I think, in this very dark gray also looks superb, especially sat on these alloy wheels. Let's have a wander on the outside first of all, and then we'll take a look, of course, at the interior. There's a couple of things to mention on the outside here. That is to give you access to the toilet cassette, so that's for emptying the loo, and the little fella underneath that is the drain for the grey water system. If we come right on back, you can see that's where the 240 volt power plugs in, and then we can open these rear doors, and there's quite a nice bit of storage in underneath here. So we can open that one and that one, and you can see there's a bit of space there for some folding bikes or whatever else you'd like to take with you. And some of the electrical systems are in there as well. Let's close that one back up. That handle there is for the awning. It's an option on this, but this one has it. And so you'll see that just along there. You can see the illumination on it. In fact, this one's also got a solar panel on the roof. And there's a Cat 1 alarm system on this as well. So you can set this up so that it will have motion sensors inside. Or if you're sleeping in it, you can set it up so that the doors are alarmed, but the interior isn't, which is quite a nice feature. Anyway, let's head on inside because I really want to show you the interior of this one. I think it's rather smart. Opens up here, like so. And then there's a switch here that powers the step out. And I think the most obvious thing, first of all, is the lighting. You can see they've done some really nice, subtle lighting on this one. It looks very inviting indeed. I do like the way they've done that. And then on the interior, look at this piped leather that they've put on these seats. I think that looks really good. So it's the Mercedes, as I mentioned. So you've got the Mercedes steering wheel and controls. It's all very nicely finished. You can see all that just there. Another thing you've got here as you come in is the control panel. So that's up here, and this is giving you access to things like your water levels, your battery monitoring, all that kind of thing is all switched from there. The 12 volt systems as well is turned on and off from there. And then just behind me over on this side, you can see how this extends the seating all the way around. These little sockets that you can see, there's one there and there's another one just down underneath here. Those are for a table leg that comes out like a swan neck, and then there's a table that goes on top of it. In fact, the actual leg for it lives up. You can see it's just in here. I'll show you where the table actually is in a moment. This is storage up in behind here. And the other thing that you can see here is the heating. So that runs off of the LPG system, and that's a TV aerial socket. There's a TV aerial on the roof, which means you can mount a TV on here if you want to. There's one fitted already at the back, but if you want another one there, then you can do it. The kitchen is over on this side. Again, some nice little lighting solutions down in places like this. This is an extension so that you can increase the work surface if you want to. Sink is underneath here, and then there's a ceramic and a gas hob, and the oven is underneath it. That one there is one of the tables that we mentioned. So that's the large table. There's a smaller table as well. So depending on whether you're dining or whether you're just having a drink, you can set it up how you like. Cutlery in there, and then drawers underneath here. They all feel very nice in the way that they slide as well, actually. Lovely. And again, concealed lighting. You can see it underneath here. Let's head on back a bit further. We've got the toilet on this side. So this slides across like so, and there it is. And that, as I say, is where the cassette can be taken from the outside. There's a shower in here as well. You can see that is up there. And again, some nice lighting and some nice bits of storage about the place. And then the sink, of course, down underneath it. Let's close that one back up. There's a fridge here, pretty decent size. And in fact, there's also a cold storage underneath it as well. And then above that, there is a microwave built in just there. And then right at the back of the vehicle, this is the sleeping area. Now you can have this specified with a double bed, or you can have it as this one is with the two singles. The two singles works quite well because you can walk down between them and step up and in. So that does make them a bit more convenient. But as I say, if you want a double then you can have it. There's more storage tucked away in places like this, and some neat little reading lights as well back under the back here, like so. Very nice. And that is a TV that's fitted in at this end of the vehicle. And down underneath, well, then you've got drawers down underneath here, so plenty of room for all your bits and pieces. That one there takes you into that boot area that we saw from the outside, so you can get to stuff without going round and out into the wet if it's raining. And then finally up here, if we slide this one open, you'll see there's the small table is in here as well. So whether you're dining or just having a cocktail, you can set that up however is appropriate. That's excellent. Let's come right to the back and have a look forward. I think that is a very smart motorhome. As I say, the detailing and the lights and the headlining and all that kind of stuff all looks really good. Skylights up in the centre as well. And there are blinds, of course, that slide across from here and from here. Very nice. Very nice indeed, actually. I'm quite taken for this one. Let's head on back up through here. Head back out. And I will just say huge thanks to you guys as ever for watching, and a huge thanks to Nick Well Motorhomes, who organised these tours for me. We'll catch you on another one very soon. Take care. Bye-bye.